As President, I'm pleased to welcome you on behalf of the faculty, staff, and governing boards of Weber State University to the university's 138th commencement. The prelude and processional music were performed by the Weber State University Wind Ensemble, conducted by Dr. Thomas Root. Seated on the platform are members of the Board of Trustees, Alan Hall, Jim Beardall, Brian Bowles, Kyle Braithwaite, Camille Kane, Mary Hall, Catherine Lindquist, and Kevin Sullivan. We're very pleased to have with us today Paul Thompson, past president of the university. Also seated on the platform are Keith Buswell, Megan Holbrook, Scott Marquardt, Carol Murphy, Mark Stoddard, and Teresa Tyre, members of the Utah State Board of Regents. In addition, Bill Cederberg, Commissioner of the Utah System of Higher Education, is in attendance. Faculty, staff, student body officers, and past honorary degree recipients are seated on the floor. I would especially like to acknowledge our faculty and staff who are retiring this year. We appreciate their dedication and service to the university, and we wish them well in their new endeavors. Let's give them a round of applause. Welcome, graduates. Today we gather to celebrate a major achievement in each of your lives, the conferring of your degree from Weber State University. For some of you, this is a realization of a childhood dream. For others, this may be a goal you set for yourself as an adult. In either case, commencement represents a significant milestone for you. It represents years of hard work, dedication, perseverance, and personal sacrifice, as well as your aspirations for your future. Your professors and experiences have helped you hone the critical thinking skills that will serve you well. At a time when society needs your best ideas, enthusiasm, and determination. A recent Wall Street Journal article noted that the Ogden metropolitan area was 10th in the nation for places with the highest growth in the college-educated populations during the last decade. That's an impressive achievement at a time when state and national leaders are seeking to increase the overall number of college graduates as a way to maintain America's leadership role in the world. With that in mind, I'd like to take this opportunity to learn more about the class of 2011. Graduates, please stand if you're first in your family to graduate from college. Thank you. You may be seated. Please stand if you worked part-time or full-time while attending the university. Thank you. Please stand if you participated in a service learning project, had an internship, conducted undergraduate research, or completed a capstone or senior project during your university experience. Thank you. Please stand if you have a job or you are continuing in graduate or professional studies. Please stand. Thank you. You've just demonstrated why we should all have faith in the future. Congratulations to each of you and best wishes for your future success. As you progress through life, remember that graduation does not mean the end of your connection to Weber State University. The knowledge you've gained and the relationships you've formed will last a lifetime. Approach each new day with the zeal and determination that led to your accomplishment today. Stay in touch, tell us about your successes, and don't ever forget that you bleed purple. Now you'll have the opportunity to hear from Erica Faye Larson, one of our outstanding graduates, who as a representative of the 2011 class will deliver the student address. Following Erica's remarks, Alan Hall, Chair of the Board of Trustees, will present an honorary Doctorate of Humanities to Dr. Paul Allen Cox. Erica Faye Larson is graduating today with a Bachelor of Science in Health Promotion with honors. Originally from Puebla, Mexico, Erica and her family moved to California when she was 10 years old. As a university student, she volunteered with numerous nonprofit organizations, which took her to places such as Peru, Brazil, and Ghana. She is a recipient of Weber State University's Excellence in Service Honor. Erica has worked as a medical assistant for several Intermountain healthcare clinics. Her plans for the future include obtaining a master's in public health, as well as working with her husband in local community health centers. She also plans on serving international communities through the nonprofit organization Volunteers Involved in Development Abroad, which her husband founded in 2002. Erica and her husband are excited to welcome their first child this spring. Ladies and gentlemen, Erica Faye Larson.
Thank you, President Milner. I feel very honored to be here. Above my bookshelves hang the words of George Santayana, which read, "The wisest mind has something yet to learn." Santayana was a Spanish-born philosopher who studied and eventually taught at Harvard University. Like Santayana, I too was born in a different country and later moved to the United States. I can vividly recall feelings of frustration at the task of learning English during those first few years. I was so confused as to why words like knife start with a K. And I didn't think I'd ever know the difference between jello and yellow. Yeah. It seems so unimaginable to me that I would ever learn this new language. Even more unimaginable was the thought that I would someday obtain a college degree. Thus, I feel privileged to have come this far. Every one of us has had unique experiences that have led us to where we are today. For some of us, it has been more challenging than others. For example, there are some of us who have had to work or raise a family or both while attending school. Some of us earned scholarships which financed our education, while others have paid every cent from personal earnings. There are some of us who have struggled with school from the beginning and perhaps even encountered thoughts of giving up along the way. Some of us today stand proud to be the first in our families to receive a college degree. There may be some of us who have journeyed through this college experience far from home or without any support. There are also many of us who, on the other hand, have had the support of family and friends every step of the way. Regardless of our experiences and circumstances, I want to emphasize today that we have all been privileged to receive this education. Having lived in and traveled to other less fortunate countries, I can confidently say we are privileged. we have been privileged to learn of things which we are most passionate about. We have been privileged to be instructed by professors who have devoted their life to our progress. We have also been privileged to have received an education from this institution whose mission statement embraces diversity and freedom of speech. So let us contemplate on this privilege, and let us also live up to it. Let us live up to this privilege by using our education to influence our communities towards improvement and progress. When appropriate, let us also use our education to assist other communities afar that may need our assistance. Let us constantly refine our new knowledge and skills as we become more adept in our professions. Lastly, let us live up to this privilege by continuing to educate ourselves. Though this day may mark the end of formal schooling for some of us, let it not be the end of our lives' schooling. Let us be wise, as Santayana once counseled, and continue always a life of learning. Congratulations, class.
Progress to me would be setting goals and then just working your hardest to achieve those goals.
It's a process.
Research is the key in progress.
Progress for me is just moving ahead to get my master's, strive to gain knowledge.
It's reaching your goals and your dreams.
Progress is beating cancer and graduating with a bachelor's from Weber State University.
This is Lyndon Draper, and she is my mentor. She has given me a lot of guidance for my honors project here at Weber State.
Professor Dr. Lauren Fowler, she has guided me in all my research. I had the opportunity to present my research in Washington, D.C. Last spring. I've taken every class I think she has to offer at Weber State.
Life is all about progress. Everything you do in athletics is about progress, progressing through, starting in one point and ending in a better point. This is my position coach, Tom Stack. He's helped me not only on the field in getting better in football, but he's also helped me in the classroom. He's helped me push myself academically to boundaries that I didn't know that I had.
I am Brianne Thomas. I am progress. The tempo in music, there is always a beat, a rhythm, a pulse. So music is progress.
My professors definitely push progress. Dr. Palumbo, Dr. Priest, Dr. Root for his happiness and support, and for all of the office hours that many countless teachers have provided.
I'm the mother of five, and this is Dr. Chloe Merrill, the chair of the Department of Child and Family Studies. She told me it's my time to shine.
I mean, I had no clue what organic chemistry was, and then I took a class from Dr. Davies, and that just kind of blew my mind.
The light going on for Calculus 1, I think that was probably the point at which I truly believed that I could finish, that I could get to the point of walking across that stage and picking up that diploma.
This picture is just of the mountaintop, and it reminds me that the sky is the limit and that anything you can dream, you can achieve.
This is a picture of me on May 31st. I was getting ready for surgery. It was my second surgery to get rid of the cancer that had grown back and had spread to my lymph nodes. In this picture, you see a scared student, not quite sure of her future. And here before you, I stand as a graduate of Weber State University, knowing for sure who I am and where I want to be.
I would be honored to thank my professors, Paul Eberle, Lisa Trujillo, Mitch Oki, and Janelle Gardner for my fantastic education and for the support they've given me through my hard times and my great times. Education is progress to me.
There's a feeling here that everybody wants to help you succeed.
Progress is advancement. I do love medicine. I'm better able to help my community. The picture in my right hand represents medicine that was in the past, and the picture in my left hand represents medicine, modern medicine today. Well, there you go. I hate being in front of the camera, but I could save your life. We are progress.
Mom and Dad, thank you very much. I'm so grateful to have you two as parents. I couldn't have done this without you. This is a really, really great feeling.
This picture is of my mom and my four children. Obtaining my master's degree shows my children a great path to take in order to succeed in life.
Also my husband, he has been great in supporting me in every decision that I've made through my educational process and putting up with me and my lack of sleep.
I really want to thank my grandma because she came and lived in my home to watch my little girl, and I'd come home exhausted and she'd be like, "Have you eaten? Here's some food." My mom is very much so my emotional support. She is just my backbone. She's there to push me on the days I want to give up.
I want to thank my husband for his support and his encouragement for the times that I was down, and he told me I could do it, and he believed in me and he would be there to help me through it. And I want to thank my oldest daughter for taking the time out of her university schedule to help me finish up mine.
So in my picture is my husband and my two bonus kids, Maya and Sam. And I would love to tell them, because they are here today, how much I love them, how grateful I am that they stood by me and made sure that I graduated.
You don't do it alone. You do it whether through your team, your coaches, your friends, especially your family. You know, there's a lot of people rooting for you.
That's another step in the right direction.
Success.
I'm graduating.
I'm Heather Wakirka, and I am progress.
I am Amber Price, and I am progress.
My name is Dan Van Leeuwen, and I am progress.
I am Polly Larson, and I am progress.
I am Michelle Burton, and I am progress.
I am Amy Friend Perkins, and progress.
I am Vicki Ross, and I am progress.
My name is Tyrell Francisco, and I am progress.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We will now proceed with the awarding of the honorary degree of Doctor of Humanities. This is the highest honor Weber State University confers upon an individual, and we are pleased to award such a degree today. President Milner, honored guests, distinguished faculty, it is a recommendation of the Board of Trustees and of the faculty of Weber State University that the honorary degree of Doctor of Humanities be conferred on Dr. Paul Allen Cox. Will Camille Kane and Brian Bowles, members of the Board of Trustees, please escort Dr. Cox to the podium and assist in the hooding. He looks pretty handsome in those robes, doesn't he? Especially with that purple on. Although Dr. Paul Allen Cox is associated with numerous universities here in the United States and around the world, no one could ever describe our honorary degree recipient as an ivory tower academic. His more than 30-year career as an educator and scientist has been filled with real-world accomplishments. After graduating with honors from Brigham Young University in 1976, Dr. Cox earned an impressive array of fellowships from prestigious institutions, including the Fulbright Program of the U.S. State Department, the National Science Foundation, Melbourne University in Australia, and the Miller Institute for Basic Research at the University of California at Berkeley. He was also named a Presidential Young Investigator by President Ronald Reagan and selected as the first King Carl Gustav XVI Professor of Environmental Biology by the Swedish Royal Academy of Sciences. Over the years, much of Dr. Cox's research effort has focused on developing medicines derived from plant remedies used by traditional healers in the Pacific Islands and Southeast Asia. As a result of his discovery of a potential anti-HIV AIDS medicinal remedy, he was named one of 11 heroes of medicine by Time Magazine in 1997. Dr. Cox continues his botanical research as director of the Institute of Ethnomedicine in Jackson Hole, Wyoming. He has also achieved notable successes in the field of environmental conservation. Dr. Cox founded the award-winning environmental charity, Seacology, which pioneered the preservation of more than 1.8 million acres of rainforest and coral reefs on islands in 46 countries around the world. In recognition of the crucial role he played in the establishment of a U.S. national park in American Samoa and rainforest preserves in Western Samoa, Dr. Cox was awarded the Goldman Environmental Prize and shared the Rachel Carson Environmental Award with Senator Tom Harkin of Iowa. Having twice earned the famed Bodine Prize for Literature as a graduate student at Harvard University, it's no surprise that Dr. Cox is also the accomplished author of 4 books and 179 scientific papers. In recognition of a life selflessly dedicated to medical research, scientific inquiry, and environmental preservation, the Board of Trustees and President F. Ann Milner, on behalf of Weber State University, confer upon Dr. Paul Allen Cox the degree of Doctor of Humanities. There you go, sir. What an accomplishment you've achieved. You're so deserving of it today. Now lay it on. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Cox.
Well, I'm really humbled to be with you today. And President Milner, Weber State staff and faculty members, families and friends of the graduates, I want to thank you all for allowing me to become the newest member of Weber State's University Class of 2011 in receiving with you a college degree. And this will be a memory I treasure for my entire lifetime. Congratulations to all of my fellow graduates. Today's graduates, and I understand there's 1,900 in number, come from 32 states, 12 foreign countries. The average age of our graduates is 26 years old. Our oldest graduate today is 60 years old. The youngest graduate today for an associate degree is 17 years old and 19 for a bachelor's degree. Each of today's graduates have their own story, as we saw in the video. And I so much want to thank our student graduation speaker, Erica Larson, who expressed so much of what I want to say today. I want to tell you a few of these stories. Consider, for example, that of Arnold Perales from Syracuse, Utah. Arnold graduates today with a bachelor's degree in health administrative services. Arnold overcame a troubled childhood, and today he is the first member of his family to receive a college education. Arnold Perales paid for his college expenses by combining academic scholarships and grants with full-time work. And yet what I find astonishing is that despite that heavy load, Arnold found time to volunteer in the Oasis Community Garden. Arnold writes, quote, "College has made me realize how important an education is. It has made me look at the world from a different perspective. Overall, college has made me a better rounded individual. I have overcome a lot in my lifetime and still managed to fight and strive for my goal, end of quote. Another one of our graduates today is Jenny Largent, who graduates today in athletic training. Jenny lost her father in a tragic accident 8 years ago, but she's been encouraged and supported by her brothers and sisters, and particularly by her mother, Lisa Largent, who's a staff member here at Weber State. Her mother wrote me about Jenny, quote, "The faculty members have been tremendous in giving her research opportunities, community service, and clinical experience. I couldn't have asked for a better experience for her," end of quote. J.C. Oram, who played football for the Wildcats and became an All-American, struggled with the deaths of several family members and other family hardships. But J.C. triumphed over many hardships, and he just receives his degree today in sales and marketing. This story of a student athlete overcoming adversity is very inspiring to me. Closer to my own field of study is that of Jennifer Schmaltz of Riverdale, Utah. Jennifer spent 2 years researching the pygmy rabbits near Woodruff, Utah. Did you know there's a special species found only there? Jennifer admits that the rabbits have a cute factor. Quote, Jennifer writes, "I think it's awesome that we have the smallest of something right here in Utah. It's the only place that has the smallest rabbit in the entire world," end of quote. Jennifer credits three WSU professors, Sam Zeveloff, Barbara Wachoki, who serves as chair of the botany department, and Michelle Skopjek, for encouraging her in her research. And I'd just like to say, Jennifer, that based on my own experience, driving between Jackson Hole and Ogden through Woodruff, Utah, that I don't think it's the dazzling nightlife of Woodruff that has stunted the growth of those rabbits. I think it's truly genetic. So, as President Milner mentioned, there's a fascinating story behind each of today's graduates, because so many have made such great sacrifices to get to this day. Most of our students that we saw have saved diligently prior to entering college, and a majority have worked since enrolling. Some have had to commute long distances to and from their employment to campus. All of our graduates have had friends and family members who've helped them along the way. Graduates, please remember to express gratitude to your parents, your spouse, other family members and friends who have helped you win your diploma. And graduates, please also remember those faculty members and staff who've made a special effort to reach out to you. Take a moment out today and write them a short note expressing your gratitude. Having an attitude of gratitude will help you live a happier and more fulfilling life. Now, since we have the Board of Regents present, I'd like to just say that, in my opinion, Weber State University, and particularly the Weber State faculty, adds more value to each student than any other institution in this state. And the reason I say that is there's a lot of students here who never dreamt they could pursue a college education, who never dreamed that they could make it to this day. But because this faculty reached out to them, because this faculty cared, because this faculty taught them, because this faculty mentored them and held them in their hearts, these students have succeeded. The college diploma that the students receive today will help them earn a better living, particularly as our recession begins to recede. The 2008 U.S. Census estimates that a college degree is worth about $1 million in additional lifetime earnings compared with a comparable worker with only a high school diploma. Now, though there's no guarantee, graduates, that your college education will make you wealthy, there is a promise that I can give you that lifelong learning will allow you to lead a richer life. And by leading a richer life, I mean the ability to enjoy a great work of art, to delight in a well-crafted poem, to be dazzled by scientific explorations of our universe. By leading a richer life, I mean the ability to engage people of different cultures, to appreciate and dignify those individuals who have opinions and viewpoints different from your own, and the ability to be of greater value and greater service to your community. And by leading a richer life, I mean the ability to enjoy life at its fullest, regardless of your income level. And realize that each day we have on this planet is precious, and that day will never return to us again. I fear that too often, the power of a university to issue a credential is touted, while the power of education to enrich lives is overlooked. And as we see that college education has increasingly become a commodity in the marketplace, with shares of not-for-profit universities being listed on the NASDAQ and New York Stock Exchange, I think we forget the magic that can be created in a classroom by a gifted teacher such as this faculty at Weber State University. When I entered the university, I was frightened. I was the son of a national park ranger. I didn't know if I could make it. I became very enamored of a professor of philosophy who was austere, demanding, but virtually revered by the student body. And I determined to try to take every class he taught. My first papers to him were filled with red marks. Occasionally, if I made a silly or perhaps a facetious statement, he had a characteristic raise of the eyebrow that would be directed like a laser towards me. But I remember one day in a class where he had me write an entire essay every week, one day my essay came back and it had on it the words, "You write well." I floated home that day, and that compliment has carried me through my lifetime. The greatest surprise I had today is when that professor walked into this auditorium. Could you please join me in welcoming my professor, Professor Chauncey Riddles, Professor Emeritus of Philosophy at Brigham Young University. Please stand, Chauncey. Let us never forget the power of a teacher to touch a student's life. No matter what box or computer program or structure or model you have, nothing can replace that imprint that great teachers give to us. And as college textbooks, in my opinion, increasingly resemble dictionaries, I mean, honestly, if you drop these things on your foot, you'd break it. And as broad liberal arts courses disappear from our curricula in favor of technical, narrow, online courses, I fear that universities and colleges will have increasingly diminished power to create that magic and to generate sparks in the minds of their students. Quote, "A university is not a dictionary, a dispensary, nor is it a department store," unquote, wrote David O. McKay, who led this institution and occupied President Milner's position from 1902 through 1906. He continued, quote, "It is more than a storehouse of knowledge, and more than a community of scholars. University life is essentially an exercise in thinking, preparing, and living." I like David O. McKay's suggestion that your Weber State University education has been about thinking, preparing, and living. And so as your fellow graduate today, I'd like to share with you my own story of thinking, preparing, and living. Soon after I received my PhD, I received the very sad news that my mother would soon die of breast cancer. I considered going back to medical school to study oncology. Maybe I could help dozens of people in my career. But then I wondered if maybe there just might be something special that I personally could do to fight the disease that had taken the life of my mother. In this, I was inspired by Harvard sociologist Robert Cole's book, The Call of Service. Robert Cole's explained that when your particular interests, your proclivities, your gifts intersect with a deep societal need that you're probably hearing a call. So I stopped and assessed what gifts, what proclivities, what interest I had. I was a botanist with a PhD in tropical biology. Because of my former missionary service for my church, I spoke several Polynesian languages. I've been steeped in conservation, growing up in the home of National Park Ranger and Superintendent. My wife, Barbara, was from a similar background. Her father, Jack Wilson, spent his life protecting land and forests from man-made and national hazards. In fact, the Interagency Fire Center in Boise is named after him. So given these unusual circumstances, I got out a map of the Pacific and started searching for a remote island that had a large standing rainforest and an intact culture. Because I decided that rather than go back to medical school to study oncology, I would go to the islands to see if the villagers could direct me to healing plants that could help treat this illness, the breast cancer that had taken my mother's life. I knew there was only a slight chance, perhaps less than 1%, that I would succeed, but it seemed well worth my time. Within a few months, Barbara, our four children, and I were living in a small thatched hut. It didn't have any running water or electricity. It was seated on a beautiful sand beach in this remote island. But we were so happy. All we took with us, other than my research gear, were the children's school books. And for recess, they'd run out to the tidal pool and have a break in what we called hut school. We spent that entire year living in a thatched hut while I studied medicine with native healers. I was fluent in their language, but I soon realized I didn't know the words or even the categories of their diseases. And I unfortunately discovered that they did not even have in their language a word for breast cancer. The only plant that they could show me was something they used to treat a condition they called lumpy breast. When I returned samples of that to my colleagues at the U.S. National Cancer Institute in Bethesda, Maryland, it turned out to be totally inactive against all the cancer cell cultures they maintained. But despite this setback, I continued my ethnobotanical studies of the island's healing plants. Then one day, a healer showed me a plant she used to treat something she called Fiva Sama Sama, characterized by yellowing of the eyes, yellowing of the skin, general jaundice, swelling of the spleen, and bad cases, hemorrhage, and death. Blood tests revealed that she was talking about hepatitis. Careful analytical work by my colleagues at the National Cancer Institute resulted in isolating from that plant a new drug treatment, a new candidate for the treatment of HIV/AIDS called Prostratin. Was I happy? I'd proven the value of indigenous knowledge, of listening to the wisdom of the elders. Despite my failure in discovering a new treatment for breast cancer, I'd open up a whole new promising avenue in AIDS research, an avenue that's being pursued actively today. But then disaster struck. I'll never forget the sound of the chainsaws and the roar of the bulldozers when the logging company showed up and starting destroying the forest where I had collected that plant. The villagers were upset by the destruction. The children were weeping. I asked them, why did you let these guys in here? They explained to me that they had no other way to raise the money they needed to build a school for their children. Otherwise, their children would have no education. I thought about this and approached the village chiefs with a startling proposition. What if I could raise money for this school? Could you stop the destruction? In response to my offer, two village chiefs grabbed their machetes, ran up to the rainforest, and chased the bulldozers away. So I returned back to Barbara, my wife, with good news and bad news. Good news was that we had saved a 30,000-acre lowland rainforest, maybe one of the last in the entire Pacific. The bad news was that we would have to sell our house, our car, and maybe one of our children to get the money in time, because I needed to get $85,000 fast. Students and graduates, you know if your marriage is working at a moment like this. Barbara paused, then she took my hand, looked in my eyes, then she said, "Paul, how often in our life will we get a chance like this? Let's go for it." Barbara, would you please stand? With her support, we started cashing out. We started selling everything we had. Word spread, however, among our family members, our friends, even students. Without me even asking anybody, money started showing up under my office door in little envelopes. Students had little badges. And within 6 weeks, I put $85,000 into my backpack, flew back to Samoa, and we didn't even have to lose our house. When I marched with that village to the logging company headquarters, and we paid those guys off, the villagers started cheering. It was the best day, well, the second best day of my life. The best day was the day I married Barbara. Soon, other villagers started approaching me. They needed schools and hospitals, too. Loggers wanted to buy their rainforests. So Barbara and I, with a few friends, established a little not-for-profit organization, which we called Seacology, because of the interface of the rainforest and the islands. And it was basically just a way to try to protect our own gifts and those of our friends to make them tax-exempt. Today, Seacology is a thriving enterprise, and it's headquartered in Berkeley, California. And what happened on that island when Barbara said those words to me launched me on a trajectory I could have never imagined when I was an undergraduate student or even graduated with my bachelor's degree. I'd founded an international conservation organization called Seacology. And despite my lack of business experience, my bad haircut, my inability to raise funds, many good people and several companies right here in Utah got behind our charitable venture. So far, Seacology has protected over 1.8 million acres of rainforests and reefs. It's built 222 schools, clinics and water supplies, and public projects in 121 islands in 46 countries. I could have never dreamed that would be possible. What an amazing thing. Seacology now has offices in Berlin, Oslo, London, and Tokyo. So when the tsunami hit last March in Japan, I jumped on the aircraft. It was empty. Not a lot of people wanted to continue their vacation. Flew to Japan to confer with the board of Seacology Japan. I met with them in a very darkened Tokyo. They turned the lights down because of the Fukushima plant had to be protected. On my way there, I got statistics and saw a little island off the coast called Oshima. I suggested we focus our release efforts there on this little island, a place I'd literally picked off the map, because I feared that that would be the last place that government assistance would be getting there. This would be the last place the water would get down the cornrow. My daughter Jane, who's now a high school senior, went with me to Oshima last summer. The tsunami damage there was so horrific. These large boats breached, houses ripped from their foundations, large fuel tanks that had been crushed on the rocks that appeared to me that an atom bomb had gone off. Those fuel tanks spilled fuel on the ocean, and when it ignited, it lit the forest on Oshima. These villagers who had lost their loved ones and seen their houses swept away started beating those flames with their own clothes. A team of them went up through the fire, up to the 10,000-gallon water tank and released it, extinguishing the flames. They gave me a shirt when I got there that had Japanese characters printed for Team Stupid, Obakata, because they said, "We're too stupid to know you can't fight a fire, forest fire with your own clothes." On this little island, tsunami waves had actually approached from both sides at one point and crashed together. When Jane and I were there, we discovered that 41 children had lost their homes So Jane and I decided to try our best to help out. We flew back to the U.S. We contacted an internationally renowned classical pianist from Yale, Tanya Bannister, and we held a charity concert for those children in Oshima. Jane produced a professional recording of that concert. Her sales of the CDs have now grossed $12,400. Now, $12,400 is a small amount to take care of 41 children, but coupled with the tremendous example by our colleagues in Japan who were driving up there, they gave them a boat, they took tons of supplies, it attracted the attention of a major company here in Utah that has as their mission statement that they want to be a force for good. The name of that company is New Skin. Last week in Oshima, Japan, and I just flew in from Japan, New Skin pledged over $400,000 to help those homeless children. The CEO of New Skin Enterprises and chairman of the board is here, Mr. Blake Roney. Would you please join me in thanking Mr. Roney for what his company has done? What I've discovered, though, is that just because you're trying to do something worthwhile or good doesn't mean that you'll always win. And I have to tell you, quite frankly, my ethnobotanical research in the islands, unfortunately, I did not find a new drug against breast cancer. This is an effort that's eluded me. But I discovered something along the way totally unexpected, a new drug for HIV/AIDS. And the ethnobotanical approach to drug discovery, which I employed in Samoa, has led to new discoveries. I just was in Sydney where we announced a new drug candidate for treating ALS. We've been focused now on tangled diseases, Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, ALS, also known as Lou Gehrig's disease. ALS is a really terrible disease with no known cause and no known cure. The period between first diagnosis and death for patients averages about 2 years, although some patients fortunately live much longer. The first ALS drug derived from the research of myself and our colleagues, the Institute for Ethnomedicine in Jackson Hole, enters this month phase 2B human clinical trials at 6 sites throughout the United States. There are 60 ALS patients enrolled. If the first 6 months show a slowing of symptoms, an additional 60 patients will be added for a total of 120 patients. And last week at the International ALS MND Congress in Sydney, we announced a second new drug candidate emerging from our research. Now, I have to tell you that both of these drugs are long shots, but all of my scientific team, as well as all of the patients enrolled in these trials, are hoping and praying that one of these just might work, that it might just slow the disease. And if not, we're not giving up. We're just going to keep going till we can find a drug that can stop ALS. So I want to thank you. So, trying to save rainforests around the world, you know, we're still losing about 40 hectares per minute. Trying to provide aid to tsunami survivors, trying to discover new medicines for our most serious diseases, these are not easy endeavors. And I think any reasonable person would conclude that I only have a tiny chance of it succeeding at any one of these things. But I take a lot of courage from the words of the French philosopher Albert Camus. Considering the Greek myth of Sisyphus, the man who was condemned to spend each day pushing a large stone up the mountain only to have it roll back, Camus wrote, "The struggle itself toward the heights is enough to fill a man's heart." Say that again. The struggle itself towards the heights is enough to fill a man's heart. One must imagine Sisyphus happy. And engaged in my own struggles of the heights, I found Camus to be right. Trying to protect island biodiversity, trying to help tsunami victims, trying to help cure serious diseases, even if I don't succeed ultimately, it's a deeply satisfying way to spend my days here on Earth. Now, the progress we've made so far still seems to me to be miraculous. And I don't tell you these things to brag, okay? I just want to acknowledge the goodness of God in my life and to express astonishment that such a small act of compassion, the kind words and optimism of my wife Barbara to me, put me on such a different trajectory and path than I could have ever imagined. A wise man long ago said that by small means, great things can be brought to pass. So graduates, as you find in your own lives, your interests and talents and gifts intersect with deep societal needs. I believe you're hearing what Robert Coles called the call of service. And when you hear that call, I urge you to respond in the same spirit of my wife, Barbara, when I asked her to choose between giving up our home or saving a rainforest. Barbara said, "Paul, how often in our lives will we get a chance like this? Let's go for it. Never let the opportunity to serve pass you by." As David O. McKay suggested, the world will be better for your thinking. The world will be better for your preparing. And the world will be better for your living because of what you've done here at Weber State University. I want to congratulate all of you on your hard work. Congratulations to my colleagues on the faculty. Thank you for this degree. And go Wildcats. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. And thank you, Dr. Cox. We shall now proceed with the conferring of certificates, diplomas, and degrees to the graduates. Yes, it's what you came for, right? The candidates for graduation will be presented by Provost Michael Vaughn.
Will the candidates for institutional certificates, the Associate of Applied Science, the Associate of Pre-Engineering, the Associate of Science, and the Associate of Arts, please rise and please remain standing. Will the candidates for the Bachelor of Integrated Studies, Bachelor of Science, Bachelor of Fine Arts, Bachelors of Arts, Bachelors of Music, and Bachelors of Music Education, please rise. And finally, I ask that the candidates for the Bachelors of Arts in English, the Masters of Arts in English, the Masters of Education in Curriculum and Instruction, the Masters of Science in Athletic Training, the Masters of Health Administration, the Masters of Science in Nursing, the Masters of Criminal Justice, the Masters of Business Administration, the Masters of Accounting, and the Masters of Taxation, to please rise. President Milner, as the Provost of Weber State University, I have the honor to present these candidates who have completed all of the requirements for their certificates and degrees indicated in the program of the day and are deemed worthy of this distinction.
In the name of Weber State University, upon recommendation of its faculty and by the authority of the Utah State Board of Regents, I hereby confer upon each of you the appropriate certificate and degree indicated in the program of the day. As a symbol of this achievement, will all of the candidates move the tassels from the right side of their caps to the left side. Congratulations, graduates, and now you may be seated. The graduates for certificates, associate, baccalaureate, and master's degrees will be presented by the dean of each of the academic colleges, the director of the Bachelor of Integrated Studies program, and the associate provost. You can refer to the program of the day for the order of presentation.
Casey S. Eberhard. Michelle Carpenter. Carl Barney. Ryan William Brimhall. Wilhelm Capati. Alali Muhammad. Brent Anderson. Ron Litchfield.
Anthony Daniel Sargent.
Taylor Brian Monson.
David Weaver Jr.
Travis Robert Jackson.
Eric C. Clayton.
Timothy Neal Tippetts.
Justin Archibald.
Jacob S. Hunter.
Nicholas L. Peruca.
Mikkel Elizabeth Smith.
Billy Buck Hansen.
Daniel J. Price.
Joshua Hoskins.
Rachel Cagle.
Clint Holmes.
Trent Woolsey.
Troy D. Bowden.
Erica Archuleta Higley.
Troy J. Nye.
Daniel Lee Rydalch.
Rand Sandel.
Angelo L. Mendez.
Jonathan Bierman.
Jefferson Gerbrock Bellow.
Christina A. Hunter.
Kelly C. Roberts.
Asia Godfrey.
Nick Essel.
Brock W. Taylor.
Christina Bruderer.
Aaron Michael Avner.
Chet Thompson.
John David Sitaway.
Heather J. Wakurka.
Ashley Belt.
Hala A. Mansour.
Clint Madsen.
Trevor Sean Cook.
Billy Harlow Hines.
Brandon Jeffrey Donovan.
Rick Gallagher.
Thomas W. Doxey.
Joseph C. Orm.
Nicholas J. Miller.
Jedediah Newby.
Adam S. Latin.
Heather Nay.
Brandon Moses.
Kyle Lewis Garcia.
Matthew Bruce Proctor.
Michael Meekum.
Curtis Lynn Blackley.
Seth Dickerson.
Kevin Russin.
Joshua A. Schultz.
Austin Mahoney.
Devin Alexander Irvin.
Mitchell L. Parker.
Adam E. Pitcher.
Mandy Ray Bertinoli.
Anthony Dorsey.
Corey J. Nelson.
Daniel Jones.
Jared T. Hodgkin.
Justin Ball.
Ryan Mark Page.
Jason R. Bergeson.
Bryce E. Peterson.
Marilise Gast.
Nicholas Aaron Smith.
Nicholas L. Taylor.
Sam Venable.
James D. Tenenbaum.
Adam Donald Hammond.
Benjamin Lloyd Peterson.
Brent Matthew Hansen.
Matthew Wardell Peterson.
Adam Heath.
James O. Woody.
Alden Scott Myers.
Jerry Thompson.
Perry Hilton.
Nathan Allen Redford.
Neil R. Manning.
Joshua Stephen Gardner.
Matthew Reese King.
Brent F. Littlefield.
Brandon W. Steinbiegel.
Calvin Jeremy Gardner.
Chad J. Buckway.
Marcus L. Olmsted.
Mary L. Suberville.
Benjamin R. Stillman.
Derek A. Lytle.
Brian Wayne Van Valkenburg.
Andrew S. Wild.
Jared E. Talbot.
Trevor H. Eckersley.
Chad Cloward.
Troy M. Whitaker.
Jonathan J. Arrington.
Tomoko Tamoyama.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Mariano Castillo Campos. Mark R. Palmer. Maristella Oakleberry. Benjamin T. Harper.
So we gotta read you again. All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's with great pride that I'd like to introduce you to the graduates of Dr. Ezekiel R. Dumke College of Health Professions. The first degree to be awarded will be Master of Health Administration and Master of Science in Nursing. Would the graduates come forward, please, and congratulations.
Troy M. Whitaker.
Marilyn S. Peralta.
Tomoko Tamoyama.
Clayton N. Anderson.
Cynthia R. Green.
Helen Elizabeth Mosier.
Garrett Elliott.
Cassidy Favero Wetton.
Keely A. Scamperly.
Michael James Olson.
Jonathan David Arnold.
Cammie Sue Meekum.
Megan Gibson.
Jamie Rust.
Christopher Blaylock.
Eric L. Somerville.
Vicky A. Ross.
Matt Bullock.
Stanley C. Price.
Jennifer R. Hayes.
Stacy C. Price.
Holly Larson.
Robert L. Rodham.
Marissa Lawrence Allred.
Jeffrey Leon Bowen.
Dallas Napoleon Hunken.
Amy Jean Daly.
Jason E. Scopel.
Kimberly Baxter.
Nate M. Rollins.
Lisa Ann Palmer.
Kelsey M. Muirbrook.
Adrian M. Kerr.
Megan Diana Clausen.
Brandon K. Knighton.
Jennifer Richens.
Justin Parker.
Shadrach Nuangso.
Lara Nicole Cummings.
Joy Korth.
Natalie Sherman.
Sarah Child.
Amy M. Stoddard.
Lauren Marie Bagley.
Connie F. Cottom.
Meg D. Bostwick.
Kylie Jean Morris.
Tamara Joe Steele.
Kelly Christine Gilson.
Alicia Christine Uriona.
Monica Wilson.
Joanne Clayton.
Lucia Rodriguez Jeffrey.
Corinne Hubbard.
Arnold Perales.
Jody Stanworth.
Joshua T. Pay.
Elisa Bruderer Randall.
Pamela Lynn Fowers.
Heather Q. Fornelius.
Jenny Lee Jenkins.
Ashley Nicole Bench.
Matthew J. Monson.
Todd S. Swenson.
Daryl Jasmine Blackwell.
Brooke Michelle Clayton.
Millie K. Beck.
Brett James Fearson.
Allison E. Scheel.
Kobe D. Knudsen.
Kenzie Byington.
Rebecca Fox.
Tracy E. Schaefer.
Mandy Griego.
Brianna Forbes Rayner.
Ryan Bielick.
James Matthias Jepson.
Candace V. Martindale.
Danilo Collado.
Holly L. Anderson.
Christy L. Green.
Paige Musias.
Shay Marie Hansen.
Kelly Marie Buck.
Mackenzie E. Stenberg.
L. Stan Pius.
Chelsea D. Telford.
Kevin Crusay.
Andrea Lynn Pratt.
Lisette Ruchet Chapel. Carrie Ann Pett.
Jessica Carol Stoddard.
Tracy M. Allison.
Tessa Reese.
Nikki Hepworth.
Nikki Lynn Evans.
Jody Stoddard.
Danielle Dell Butler.
Cassie Heyer.
Lindy Celeste Orr.
Emily M. Tingey.
Mary Elizabeth Chipman.
Callie Jo Vandersteen Smith.
Megan Martinez.
Sheila Janet Whitney.
Morgan Lee Martin.
Ashley Steele.
Julie DeRue.
Amber Sue Hales.
Gavin R. Crowther.
Rachel Ann Rich.
Anastasia Jane Christensen.
Jennifer King.
Alisa M. Edwards.
Justine M. Ashcraft.
Lindsay S. Whipple.
Abigail Brianne Gregerson.
Sarah Stetler.
Olivia May Fowler.
Jamie Lynn K. Bragger.
Christian Junk.
Stephanie L. Scott.
Deanne Squire Raleigh.
Brenda C. Black.
Sarah Marie Spendlove.
Chelsea Toulson Griffin.
Callie Lynn Westman.
Rachel Lungman Smith.
Samantha Lynn Hager.
Tiffany Ann Morfitt Boucher.
Sydney Sheba.
Jared Charlton.
Marie B. Carter.
Isar Chicory.
Shaylin Egli.
Penny Ba Rogers.
Allison Lamborn.
Katie Margaret Stokes.
Corey Blonquist.
Marcy Pratt.
Cambria Lee Penrod.
Christy K. Kano.
Sarah Christina Cologne.
Lori Weston Burgett.
Heidi A. Hislop.
Jennifer Weston Taylor.
Jonna Leanne Macklin.
Ashley Nicole Holmes.
Natalie Oliverson.
Edwin O. Awinda.
Constance Lynn Merrill. Melinda McMillan. Shyla Carlson.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am very pleased to present graduates of the Talitha E. Lindquist College of Arts and Humanities. The first degree to be awarded will be the Master of Arts in English. Graduates, please come forward.
Jason White.
Russell Adams.
Ashley Cross.
Sarah Marie Goronsky.
Brian Roger Christensen.
Sarah Don Lowry.
Amanda Erig.
Justin Reed Hancock.
Aaron Wolf.
Victoria A. Akpan.
Braden Kyle Jensen.
Camry Anna West.
Catherine Graff.
Chelsea Green Williams.
Brianne Thomas.
Alana Faagai.
Ordi Brigitte Budisak.
Laura Lynn R. Bardwell.
Sarah N. Milner.
Jared David Parkin.
Sonia Pence.
Amy Clunt.
Bethany Lauren Johansson.
Brandon Westman.
Julia Hinckley.
Celeste C. Seacrest.
Brittany Salt.
Evelyn C. Fitzgerald.
Braden Eden.
Kyle T. Wilcox.
Kelsey J. Anderson.
Erica Noelle Stearns.
Sophia Isabel Waugh Kerrigan.
Kevin D. Grosshans.
Heidi Ferguson Kutrubis.
Brandon D. Welker.
Emma Rose Kohler.
Jennifer Manolis Barlow.
Alicia Beth Glasscock.
Anika Black.
Dason Smith.
Jessica K. Pollard.
Morgan Sue Birmingham.
Starla K. Stanley.
Glenn Elwood Moon.
Brooke W. Coombs.
Jeffrey K. Bodily.
Patrick N. Andrus.
Matthew Starley.
Sarah Clayton.
Jessica Camille Ringler.
Ryan Robert Hatch.
Candace K. Bear.
Mauro Gabriel Fernandez.
Amy R. Wright.
Willowbrook Saunders.
Nathan Wright.
Catherine Tingey Strong.
Blake Chad Keller.
Michael A. Cummins.
Marvin Dennis Walker.
Chad Andrew Coleman. Jacob William Jensen. Scott K. McIntyre. Mark Purser. Kelly J. Cross.
We need to pull a piece of paper off. Or what college are you in?
Soraya E. Moss.
Okay, what is your name? Chelsea Rose. Cummings. Chelsea Rose Richards Cummings.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's a great privilege for me to present to you the graduates from the College of Science. Graduates, you've done it. Please come forward.
Elizabeth Marie Mora.
Jordan Lynn Stocking.
Zhang Xin.
Timothy W. Shoup.
Kenneth R. Call.
Jennifer M. Schmaltz.
Kendall M. Center.
Dan Van Leuven.
Lindsay Diane Yucky.
Crystal Borkowitz.
Brittany Antoinette Philpott.
Candalee Richardson.
Gregory Allen.
Tana Eggleston.
Jessica Lynn Bills.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to present the graduates from the Jerry and Vicki Moyes College of Education. The first degree to be awarded will be the Master of Education degree in Curriculum Instruction, followed by the Master of Science degree in Athletic Training. Would the graduates please come forward?
Sarah Vigil.
Brooke Elizabeth Grant.
Trudy A. Burton.
Jennifer Curtis.
R.C. B. Callahan.
Annie Marie Robertson.
Samantha Bills.
Emily Izuka.
Jennifer Pond.
Siwon Sharon Chung.
Shane M. Frazier.
Mark Womack.
Bridget M. Barrow.
Megan K. Parker.
Janica Johnson.
Sarah Brittany Bosch.
Erica Larson.
Rebecca Sitaway.
Julie Timmons Barker.
Arielle Masserly.
Stacy Lynn Hendricks.
Whitney Henry.
Kaylin Marie Studebaker.
Jennifer Murphy.
Terry Lynn Murray.
Kimberly Joe Thomas.
Amy Wright.
Caitlin Carol Tyrell.
Jenny Marie Largent.
Lindsay Nicole Yates.
Stephanie Holmes.
Yasko Tanabe.
Brian Huber.
Sarah Elizabeth Coons.
Brennan Foster Reese.
Bruno F. Silva.
Christopher Allen Barber.
Courtney Jean Birch.
Logan V. Anderson.
Brett Mortensen.
Tiffany L. Bradford.
Adam B. Cunningham.
Kaylin V. Drott.
Cecilia N. Wheelwright.
Crystal M. Larson.
Jeffrey Allen Joy.
Lindy J. Bent.
Shaunette Sodasanti.
Shelley Bateman.
Rachel A. Bunderson.
Rebecca L. Hartley.
Alicia Gabriel Simonson.
Brooke V. Call.
Kirsten Wood Rott.
Becca A. Cochran.
Marcy Ann Barker.
Jesslyn Bailey Anderson.
Randy Hunter.
Annie Butte.
Paige F. Cahoon.
Brittany Ann Berman.
Monica Cole.
Todd G. Barrow.
Carrie Lynn Shelton.
Natalie Nicole Kimber.
Cheryl E. Anderson.
Whitney Greenhall.
Jennifer Ann Smith.
Pamela Lee Meadows.
Amanda Rose.
Brooke Motz.
Kelsey Ann Jacobson.
Janessa Youngberg.
Tristan Joseph Ragland.
Whitney Cheryl Gines.
Brianne Gathercole.
Scott K. Smith.
Jamie Toll.
Steve O. Stewart.
Rebecca A. Johnson.
Alex Berryessa.
Walter Tab Williams.
Sean Patrick Coriel.
Josie Ann Hepworth.
Juliet Clark.
Amanda Marie Nielsen.
Kendra Fisher.
Laura McConkey.
Rachel M. Ulm.
Marianne McConkey.
Lakin Raquel Larson.
Melanie C. Tilly.
Samuel E. Hummel.
Katie Marie Toon.
Shandy Kaw.
Kimberly Marie Springer Stanley.
Jasmine Lees Freed.
Robin S. Mikama.
Angela Dawn Bate.
Samantha Dell Worston.
Mallory T. Murphy.
Jamie R. DeGraw.
Paul D. Busk.
Angela Yvonne Ward.
Whitney Brewer.
Daryl Z. Budd.
Courtney Marie Lang. Heather Hyam Moore. Jessica Smith. Janet Lewis.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I present the graduates from the College of Social and Behavioral Sciences. The first degree to be awarded is the Master of Criminal Justice. Graduates, please come forward.
Raquel Alonso.
Jennifer Lonnie Famalia.
Jomar Calderon Hiner.
Stephanie Galightly.
Amy Friend Perkins.
Sydney D. Noyce.
Maha Barlow Layton.
Megan Larkin.
Lassina Mitchell Bringard.
Katarine Torres.
Grayson L. Greener. Carrie Bogue.
Carrie J. Johansson.
Amy Trevithan Blunk.
Shad William Babb.
Julie A. Neely.
Christopher P. Malin.
Spencer Aram Arslanian.
Alex York Roberts.
John Robert Bickmore Jr.
Spencer Wayne Turley.
Whitney A. Sanderson.
Sean George.
Matthew Tyler Colton.
Matthew Stringham.
Vanessa Marie House.
Meredith Lee Mazzillo.
Danielle Janae Ravy.
Kayla Moore.
Brittany A. Barnett.
Melissa Magatti.
Tiffany Youngberg.
Michael L. Olson.
Matthew Paul Danes.
Jared M. Herdman.
Nikki K. Jensen.
Kevin Kyle White.
Noemi Erickson.
Paul Roger Lyon.
Alex Thomas Hall.
Melanie Nicole Nemo.
Steve Shane Woody.
Keely H. Beerwolf.
Susan G. Parker.
Julianne Briscoe.
Joshua B. Hartung.
Sarah R. Wheelwright.
Tirsa Brittany Green.
Abigail Lee Holbert.
Brandon L. Bates.
Brianne Marie Evans.
Sarah J. Rice.
Jared Bate.
Kimberly K. Lynn.
Lara S. Vigint.
Michelle Hall.
Brandy Jean Ballier.
Anthony Pett.
Marche Kirsten Stokes.
Lindsay Joe Bond.
Carrie Griffiths Phelps.
Emily K. McFarlane.
Dory Stinger.
Brent Stephen Waters.
Melinda K. Dunkley.
Drew Davis.
Timothy L. Chavez.
Nicholas Reed O'Neill.
John Olson.
Bonnie Ann Brady.
Angelita Alamorte King.
Evan Tinkham.
Amy R. Levy.
Weilang Lei.
Elise A. Williams.
Veronique Johansson.
Lisa D. Francis.
Andrew Stong.
Veronica Rose Chi.
Timothy Moore.
Brandon G. Baldwin.
B. Brock Rose.
James Clegg.
Adam Berman.
Joel Stephen Freston.
Charles Welty.
Daniel Allen Jewell.
Isaac G. Pantone.
Amy Marie Ward.
Chase Kaloy Peely.
Paul A. Richards.
Cherise Stegel.
Sarah Diane Rumsa.
Danny R. Spalding.
Tiana Anderson.
Michael Todd Kawabata.
Jared L. Taylor.
Stacy D. Tittle.
Daniel Gerald Clark.
Melissa Halley Ford.
Chuck R. Pulver.
Maurice Neal.
Ella K. Bingham.
Nicholas Christian Dupay.
Megan Greenfield.
Joanna D. Wachnick.
Tyrell Francisco.
Susan M. Ferguson.
Antoine Stutzen. Tamara K. Smith. Trisha L. Haslam.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor to present the graduates from the John B. Goddard School of Business and Economics. The first degrees to be awarded will be the Master of Business Administration, Master of Accounting, and Master of Taxation. Graduates, please come forward.
Hi there.
Stephanie Denise White.
Joshua David Griffin.
Joshua L. Merrill.
Jerry Bay.
Deprupa Bose.
Kungwang Sim.
Jared H. Jones.
Jonathan D. Sommer.
Clinton Travis Armstrong.
Rebecca Susan Ritchie.
Gloria C. Okeson.
Justin W. Parkinson.
Travis C. Lee.
Jedediah Cole Casper.
Sean Oram.
Jaron Campbell.
Kyle J. Krebs.
Jordan Christopher Walker.
Michael John Blackhurst.
Duncan G. Shelley.
Nate Smith.
Christy L. Smith.
Brittany Chandler.
Benjamin Thomas Barraza.
Amber M. Price.
Matt J. Budd.
Ross Murray.
Ryan D. Butcher.
Carter Parker Chase.
Michelle Harrington Feller.
Jared Duggar.
Jeremy D. Ward.
Bradley D. Pratt.
Tyler G. Randell.
Jed Ellis.
Jason J. Adams.
Marcia Gerenser.
John Shing.
Alicia Don Colvin.
Candace L. West.
Bracken Jones.
Cody Thompson.
Christopher Peterson.
Sean William Hoth.
Lacey Wayman.
Derek B. Warden.
Christopher D. Roberts.
Sarah Jean Willis.
Christian M. Greenwald.
Dallas Boyce.
Christopher Alexander Portillo.
David M. Taylor.
Michael White.
Gregory M. Benson.
B. Jonathan Kilgore.
Justin Dickamore.
Jacob T. Pruitt.
Daniel Rubal.
Jody Barton.
Nicholas A. Cronin.
Kevin M. Johnson.
Roger D. Arnell.
Randy Allred.
Chad Wheatley Gibson.
Matthew Harold Hansen.
Peter Alex Palick.
Bill Gary Young.
Wynn May Schweitzer.
Eric Rasmussen.
Mark Andrew Wackenhorst.
Abdullah Asa Elisa.
Jude Chen.
Bryce Moore Shreve.
Thomas Burton.
Tyler Hodson.
Todd Jason Perry.
Daniel J. Holloman.
Joseph Jones.
Brittany Davis Overdeek.
Jason R. Eckett.
Stephen Gerard.
Mara Correa.
Cody Duran.
Halion Corpita.
Carly Tippets Hummel.
Jeremy M. Bruning.
Nathan Alton Cox.
Lelaine Barlow.
Wendy Gaskell.
Drew H. Larson.
Michael J. Head.
Russ Kazare.
Cody Nordberg.
Raven Zhao.
Jeremy Tracozzi.
Fenglu Yu.
Don Nelson.
Mark Westergaard.
Brian Wells.
Trevor James Wood.
Eric C. Stanford.
Michelle Arbin.
Keaton Brian Woodland.
Andrew Todd Yoakum.
Matt D. Bangerter.
Amy L. Nelson.
Tan Hoa D. Nguyen.
Chui Ping Chen.
Weining Tang. San Chang.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am proud to present to you the graduates of the Bachelor of Integrated Studies program. Will the graduates please come forward?
Eric Scott Waterfall. Caitlin R. Jensen. Crystal D. Lassiter. Melissa Salmon McKinley. Lisa Stevens. Laurel L. Thomas. Kylie A. Johnson. Benjamin Joseph Linford. Kyle D. Mellon. Gary Dwayne Stumpf. Gerald Gansey. Jacob Boyd Peterson.
The final group of graduates we will recognize today are those individuals receiving the Associate of Arts or the Associate of Science in General Studies. Graduates, please come forward.
Zachary E. Gillilung.
Yadira Herta.
Robin Height Nielsen.
Sean Hogan.
Belinda Ann McElhaney.
Lindsay J. Hubble.
Perla Olivia Poston.
Kevin Sands.
Joshua R. Engelman.
Brianna Christensen.
Fabian Fernando Dominguez.
Nolan Pendleton.
Brittany Irene Edwards.
Coralyn Schreiber.
Andy J. Edwards.
Melissa Jackson Robbins.
Catherine Diana Pearson.
Megan Amanda Medina.
Ashley K. Williams.
Ethan Albertson.
Maria Wild.
Lene Bowis.
Jessica Kelsey James.
Justin Williamson.
Nathan Garrett Waugh.
Ruben A. Victorio.
Nicole P. Raleigh.
Amanda M. Slater.
Emmanuel Olivas.
Saralina D. Mastis.
Heather Davies.
Angela Chadwick.
Tiffany Marie Rupp.
Sandra L. Pippen.
Melissa Rosenvall.
Rochelle M. Johnson.
Richard Trong.
Matthew T. Woodman.
Matthew Reese Glover.
J.C. Nall.
Richard Jones.
Nicolette Paige Baliff.
Christopher Quinn Greenwood.
Stephen Menedos.
Jennifer L. Davis.
Marcus S. Charlesworth.
Sarah Palomino.
Angela Fuentes.
Nancy M. Yazzi.
Rosanna Baldraco.
Caroline Isadora Dow.
Stacy McBride.
Tara Deanne Carrasco.
Chelsea Cox.
Courtney Ann Payne.
Brittany Lee Bueller.
Garrett Richard Eberly.
Sarah Jeanette Maxwell.
Bryce Lang.
Nicole Sparks.
Matthew Nye.
Julia Marie Batchison.
Stacy Monson.
Lisa Seeley.
Brianna Penter.
Sherston Ann Palmer.
Michael Anthony Peterson. Elizabeth Ann Mehmet. Sarah A. Dunn. Ashley Marie Ryan. Faith Rachel Bushman. Amanda George. Mary Alice Williams. Pollyanne Napoli. Angela Olson Vance. Kyle Vance. Austin Snow. Bryson Snow.
As president of the Weber State University Alumni Association, I would like to invite all the alumni present today to please stand. Graduates. Graduates, today is your day, and on behalf of the Weber State University Alumni Association, it is my pleasure to extend our warmest congratulations and welcome you into the ranks of alumni of this great institution. With some of the lowest student-to-faculty ratios in the nation, you have been privileged to work closely with outstanding professors. I still remember with fondness and gratitude those professors who taught me to think critically, view the world with wonder, and make a contribution to society. You too will feel your professor's influence as you pursue your life's goals. Take time to thank them and keep in touch. And speaking of keeping in touch, one of the best ways is through the Alumni Association. We hope you will join us. Your membership will keep you informed of happenings on campus, provide opportunities for career networking and lifelong learning, and support student scholarships. Membership also includes some amazing and very exclusive benefits, so check it out online. Many challenges and opportunities lie ahead, but today, take time to savor the moment and celebrate this outstanding achievement. Again, congratulations.
Graduates, today is a personal achievement to be celebrated, but you didn't do it alone. Your family and friends encouraged and supported you in your studies, and they're here to celebrate with you today. Let's give them a round of applause. Thank you. We appreciate everyone who planned and participated in the commencement program this afternoon. If there are any in the audience who would like an additional program, they'll be available at Portal 14. For those who would like to view this ceremony, you can go to page 23 in your program. It will give you information about how to watch commencement on YouTube or obtain your personal DVD. Alumni, as you leave here today, I encourage you to continue your connection with Weber State University. We hope it's a lifelong relationship where you return to learn, to foster relationships with faculty and colleagues, to support students who will follow in your footsteps, and to engage in university activities. You will always be a part of Weber State University, a place that played a role in changing your life. Now will you please join vocalist Chelsea Rose Richards Cummings and the Weber State University Wind Ensemble in singing the school song, Purple and White. For those of you who may not yet have memorized the words, they're printed inside the back cover of the program. This will then conclude Weber State University's 138th commencement exercises. Graduates, if you would like to visit with your professors, please feel free to come down on the floor following the singing of Purple and White. Will you please rise for our school song?